look right into the camera lens right here and tell us your name, your age, and where you were born.
My last name is Lee, Bruce Lee. I was born in San Francisco in 1940. I'm 24 right now.
And you worked in motion pictures in Hong Kong?
Yes, since I was around 6 years old.
And when did you leave Hong Kong?
1959, when I was 18.
I see. Now look over to me, Bruce, as we talk. I understand you just had a baby boy?
Yeah.
And you've lost a little sleep over it, have you?
Three nights.
And tell the crew what time they shoot the pictures in Hong Kong.
Well, it's mostly in the morning because it's kind of noisy in Hong Kong, you know, around 3 million people there. And so every time when you have a picture, it's mostly, say, around 12 a.m. to 5 a.m. in the morning.
I see. They'd love that there. And you went to college in the United States?
Yes.
And what did you study?
Philosophy.
I see. Now, you told me earlier today that karate and jiu-jitsu are not the most powerful or the best forms of oriental fighting. What is the most powerful or the best form?
Well, it's bad to say the best, but in my opinion, I think Gung Fu is pretty good.
Would you tell us a little bit about Gung Fu?
Well, Gung Fu is originated in China. It is the ancestor of karate and jiu-jitsu. It's more of a complete system, and it's more fluid. By that I mean it's more flowing. There is continuity in movement instead of one movement, two movement, and then stop.
Would you look right into the camera lens and explain the principle of the glass of water as it applies to Gung Fu?
Well, Gung Fu, the best example would be a glass of water. Why? Because water is the softest substance in the world, but yet it can penetrate the hardest rock or anything, granite, you name it. Water also is insubstantial. By that I mean you cannot grasp hold of it. You cannot punch it and hurt it. So every Gung Fu man is trying to do that, to be soft like water and flexible and adapt itself to the opponent.
I see. What's the difference between a Gung Fu punch and a karate punch?
Well, a karate punch is like an iron bar, whack. A Gung Fu punch is like an iron chain with an iron ball attached to the end, and it go whang, and it hurt inside.
Okay. Now we're going to cut, and in just a second, we'll have you stand up and show us some Gung Fu and some movements in Gung
okay.
Fu.
Okay.
Cut.
Test X2, take one.
Speed.
Now look directly into the camera, Bruce. Directly at it. And now give me a three-quarter this way. And hold it. And give me a profile that way, all the way. Good, hold it. Now come back to a profile on the other side. And hold that. Give me a three-quarter on that side. And then give me right into the camera again. All right, now the camera will pull back. And Bruce, first show me the movements in the classical Chinese theater.
Classical Chinese
theater. Well, you know what we talked about in the office, how they walk and how they start to move.
Well, in Chinese opera, they have the warrior and then the scholar. The way the warrior walk will be something like this. Walking this way, straight, come out, bend, straight, and then walk out again. An ordinary scholar would be just like a female, a weakling, 90 pounds in child Atlas. You'll be just walking, you know, like a girl, real, shoulder up and everything.
So by the way they walk, you can immediately tell who they
are. Right, what character they represent.
Now, show us some Gung Fu movements.
Well, it is hard to show it alone, but I will try to do my best.
All right, maybe one of the fellas will walk in. You want to walk
yeah,
in?
It would be...
Go ahead.
Come on,
Lee. Okay.
There you go.
Although accidents do happen, but you know... There are various kinds of strike. It depends on where you hit and what weapon you will be using. To the eyes, you would use fingers. Don't worry. I will be. To the eyes. Or straight at the face, from the waist, everything on.
Hold it just a minute. Let's move this gentleman around this way so you're doing it more into the camera. Okay, well.
And then there is bent arm strike using the waist again. Into a back fist.
And let's have the assistant director back up just a way.
And then, of course, Gung Fu is very sneaky. You know, the Chinese, they always hit low. From high, go back to the groin. Don't worry.
Now turn around the other way, would you, Bruce?
Oh, okay.
Yeah. And,
Would you want him to?
Yes.
These are just natural reactions.
Right. That is natural.
Right into the camera. Cheat into the camera a little bit and show this again.
All right.
Go ahead.
There is the finger jab. There is the punch. There is the back fist and then low. Of course, then they use leg straight at the groin. All come up. Or, if I can back up a little bit, they start back from here and then come back.
All right.
It's kind of worried.
He has nothing to worry about. Now, once again, show us how a good Gung Fu man would very coolly handle it and walk away rather than get caught in a series of actions.
Cut it.
Sound.
Okay.
Test X2, take two.
Now, Bruce, so that we can clearly see what you're doing this time, we'll face the fact that there's nobody there. Okay. Show me now the difference between jiu-jitsu, which is long and involved, and Gung Fu, which is very quick if you have an opponent.
All right, for instance, you will read it in the book, in a magazine and everything, that when somebody grab you, you will first do this, and then this, and then, and then, and then, and then, thousands of steps before you do a single thing. Of course, these kind of magazine would teach you to be feared by your enemies and admired by your friends and everything. But in Gung Fu, it always involves a very fast motion. Like, for instance, a guy grabbing your hand. It's not the idea to do so many steps. Step him right on the instep. He'll let go. This is what we mean by simplicity. Same thing in striking and in everything. It has to be based on a very minimum motion so that everything would be directly expressed, one motion, and he's gone. Doing it gracefully, not to go, yelling and jumping all over him, but to do it. Excuse me. That's it.
Okay, now show me once again just a few movements there.
Well, Gung Fu can be practiced alone or with a partner. Practicing alone, they involve forms. Some imitate a crane, a monkey, a praying mantis. This is a crane form. Let's start off. Hey! This is one of the movement involved.
Show us one more movement and then we'll be all through.
Okay, well, I'm glad to hear that. They have the tiger that start like a tiger. Using claw to claw the face, or the beak of the crane to the eyes, move! This is some of the movement involved.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.